Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? The apostles asked the risen Jesus. The apostles were still clinging to what they thought was Jesus' purpose, the Christ, the Messiah, that is, that he came to restore his people, the Israelites, to their proper status, putting the world in right order again. Of course, that ignored the reality that there were other groups and peoples who were oppressed and bullied during the reign of the Roman emperors. Jesus' message was broader and comprehensive. The kingdom he was restoring, the reign he was proclaiming, was that of the kingdom of God, not man. The kingdoms of man have all too often relied on brute strength, weapons, violence, destructive power over others, as the attempts we are witnessing now in Ukraine and other parts of the world, and as the countless wars over the centuries that have taken millions of lives have demonstrated. In John's Gospel, Jesus says, you might remember we heard this on Good Friday, "If my kingdom were of this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over. But that's not the way of the kingdom of God." And earlier in Luke, Jesus says, "The coming of the kingdom of God cannot be observed, and no one will announce, 'Look, here it is,' or 'There it is.' For behold, the kingdom of God is among you," or within you. We can't keep looking for something or someone else to come and save us. He has come and shown us the way. As Mark's gospel puts it, the kingdom of God is at hand, because it already has been given to us. It was given to us from the beginning. That's what the Garden of Eden story in Genesis tells us. When we choose our own ways apart from the guidance of God, we lose paradise. That is the choice of human beings, not God. The Ascension reminds us that Jesus Christ entrusts us to build the kingdom of God on earth. We have been given what we need. Sacraments also remind us of that truth. Remember that definition. A sacrament is an outward sign of the presence of God. It has been said that Jesus is the sacrament of God, and that the church is to be the sacrament of Jesus. That may be hard to believe when we look around us and see that the church is comprised of you and me, sinful human beings. But the letter to the Ephesians we heard gives us an important perspective and truth when it says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ gave him as head of all things, over all things, to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. So when the kingdom will become fully restored is largely in our hands and our hearts. Guided by the head and spirit sent to us, but as in all things that are free, we must choose it. We must move beyond the kingdoms we prepare for ourselves and consider all that and all whom God has created. So we come here, week to week, to reflect on that, to be fed by word and sacrament, as we strive to embody both word and sacrament in the world. And here's another clue from Luke. His gospel begins and ends in the temple. At the beginning, Zechariah being visited by the angel Gabriel. And at the end, we just heard the disciples continually in the temple praising God. The temple is the place where God dwells. As St. Paul says, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit? A temple not only here, but here. Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? All that we need has been given us. We can't keep waiting for an answer to fall from the sky. For in Jesus Christ, it is already ours.